Wow. Sword of Fire, nice to say. Aura of Fellows. Aura of Fellows makes me want to take that. This is kind of tough, actually. Aura of Fellows versus Sword of Fire, nice. That is tough indeed. I think I want to stick with Aura of Fellows, though. I mean, we do have, like, Shackles, Fathom Seer, and Rampant Growth does get blue, so we can fix our blue mana that way. And Aura of Fellows is just, I think you have to take that there. Just accelerating like that is really, really important. Maybe this Verdant Cataclysm Wheel so we can get some more synergy with Oracle of Muldiah. Man, I don't usually pass swords, but when I do, it's a mistake. Ooh, so we got Sylvan or Jace. I think I'm gonna go ahead and take Sylvan here. I don't really want to play more double blue cards, especially ones that want to be played out early. We've got a. Yeah, Sylvan's just gonna be pretty sweet, I think. We've got Ice Crown Scepter for Impulse, that's the only card, so yeah, not close. And here, what do we have? We've got Everflowing Chalice, Primal Command, Old Man of the Sea. Old Man of the Sea is basically Vulcan Shackles. For Old Man's power. We've got some other cards that are pretty annoying, like Band of the Living, Eight and a Half Tails, Rolling Earthquakes, Elspeth. And they're all pretty good. And Despise. And Mortarpod can be okay. We do have Awakening Zone. But I think I'm gonna go ahead and stick with Everflowing Chalice here, because that'll add our acceleration up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. I think I'm gonna go with that. It is colorless, so that's sort of a bust, but. And then we're not going to wield this, I think. We may wield Old Man, although that's less likely. We may wield a Mortar Pod, but I kind of want more acceleration. Ooh, little Mole Drifter action. It's got destroyed last round by. Or last draft by an Ingot Fury. Ugh, blew up my Palladium here, so I couldn't cast all his dust and Platinum Angel. It was disappointing. Mole Drifter is going to be our pick. It's not very close. It'll help us draw into more blue mana, and it's a sweet picture. I mean, look at this thing. It's just like a flying fish. Although it says it's an elemental, so I'm a little confused. All right, so we've got Phyrexian Revoker and Gristlebrand and Achroma Angel of Fury. We also have Watery Grave. There was a Verdant Catacombs, so I could see taking the Watery Grave in the hopes of the Verdant Catacombs wheels. Yeah, right. Gristlebrand is pretty sick though, so if anyone ever gets that into play, kind of just want to take this because I don't really think the Catacombs is going to wheel, so taking the Grave is just not really as productive. Gristlebrand is so good. I mean, we do have a control magic though, so I mean, in that regard, it's not as big of a deal. And there is an Achroma which we just can't stop, so I guess I'll go ahead and take the Watery Grave and hope. Tidings, anyone? Thornling? Dismember? We don't have any removal except for Jitte, Shackles, Opposition. That's enough. Let's run this Tidings. It's gonna be pretty sweet. It is double blue though, but so that makes Raphelos and Leatherback Baloth kind of sucky, but I think we'll be fine. So looking at the rest of this deck, we have what are we taking out? I think we may be okay for cards. So this is probably gonna be the 23 that we're running. Ooh, jeez, those are some cards. That's pretty sick. Do we want to splash? Let's see. Rampant Growth? No. I think we're just going to take our Sylvan Light or Sphere of the Suns. Would we play that over Apocrisite? Maybe. That's tough. We could sideboard Apocrisite. Just play Sphere. That'd be okay, I suppose. Yeah, that wouldn't be that bad. All right. Gonna take show and tell and pass living death. Is that really what I'm doing? Well, we have some sideboard against living death already. We have the relic, so I'm gonna take show and tell in case we end up using it, because I don't really see playing this. And you just pass Gristlebrand and Achroma Angel of Fury, and I would really like to not deal with that. Plus we can show and tell, ooh, we can take this. That's reasonable. And passing Tinker. Don't remember any artifacts that we passed that were interesting. So go ahead and pass that. Take our scavenging ooze. We can play that. Well, we can sideboard that, maybe. So this is 24, so we'd have to cut one, which is probably going to be Apocrysite. As much as I don't want to do that. Or we could pass Impulse, but when you have opposition in your deck, you really want to be able to find it as easily as possible. And Impulse is going to do that. So here's the cutting Apocrysite. And here we have a few cards. What do we have? We have Flicker Wisp, Bogard, and Hellkite. Looks like it's going to be Hellkite for us. Could sideboard it in when we play Show and Tell. Hey, look. Old Man of the Sea came back. I don't really want to take a Memory Lapse. I'd rather take this and sideboard in against aggro decks. Or we just play this main over something random like Leatherback Baloth. That's probably going to be a little bit better. And here we'll take Mr. Tin Street Hooligan or Ingature. I think we're going to take Ingature because it is harder to cast Tin Street Hooligan. And yeah, take that Achroma. And take that Kami. Because Kami blows up opposition, and I'm not really a fan of letting that happen. Ooh. So, Verdant Catacombs didn't wheel. Just a big shocker there. Our deck's okay. Yeah, it's a little bit more mid-rangey than I care for, but that's the way things go sometimes. We've got some pretty good cards. We have Opposition and Shackles, and some not-as-good cards like Impulse. So I'm going to go lay this out, and we'll see what it looks like in a little bit. Okie dokie. So I think these are, well, these are 24 cards here, and we can only run 23, so we're going to have to cut one. Going over the sideboard, we have a few sideboard options. For aggro, we can bring in Moments Piece and Apocrysite, potentially Manriki if we're playing against more equipment like that sword. Although we've got some main deck ways to handle that. Some opposition also that doesn't really deal with sword body or body mind or fire and ice. And we also have some Reanimator sideboard and Random Ray of Revelation. And so looking at the main deck. Some of the suspect cards include this 8-mana guy, although, I mean, with the way our deck is right now, he's a little more mid-range, although I still think he's worth running. And then we have, let's see, what's sort of creatures that are birdly do-nothing guys. We have Troll Ascetic, we have Leatherback Baloth, and that's about it. I'm happy playing with Old Man of the Sea, and Fathom Seer's fine, not great. And then we have, let's see, all of our colorless acceleration, I think since we're pretty light on the early game, is necessary, like Chalice and Sphere. Sphere especially because we've got so much, we're so color heavy. And then we also have Sylvan, which is good, Jitte, which is good, and Impulse, which is serviceable. I mean, it's going to find one of our good cards, so I want to run that. I think what I want to do is cut one of these 3-mana creatures. I don't really want to cut this guy, though. We're a little light on the ramp, so, I mean, that makes this guy less good, but he does so much stuff. I think he's worth running. So it comes down to whether, I think, it's Phantom Seer or Troll Ascetic or Leatherback. So we can make a cut based on what our deck is going to look like in terms of the mana base. Let's take a quick look at our stats. Given in mind that we are playing with the Dalkin Shackles also, so it's like a third versus 50 in favor for blue and then green. And we have a bunch of green one and two drops plus rampant growth. So I think I'm going to run something like 10-7, which doesn't really make Shackles work out all too well, but, you know, what are you gonna do? So I think what we can do is probably cut either the Baloth or the Troll Ascetic or the Fathom Seer. And I think it's probably gonna be Fathom Seer. It's just, I mean, it's good with Oracle, but it just requires, it's not very impactful on the board. And it ends up being really slow. So I think it's gonna be better like this. And we can run it like this, run something like 10.7, add land, suggest 10.7. Look, we got it right. So says Magic Online. So we're going to go ahead and submit this, and get started with round one, and hopefully get our Benny beatdown on it, because, man, this deck's got some pretty sweet cards. So I'll see you then.